Peter Spiller is joining us here on Proactive London this morning from Capital Gearing Trust. A very good morning to you, Peter.
Good morning, Katie.
So before we get stuck into all of the details, let's get an introduction as to exactly what your trust does and what you stand for.
Okay. So what the trust does is look after, in principle, all the financial assets of an individual or an institution which has the same view of life as I do for my own portfolio. That is to say, they have an aversion to losing money. Yeah. They're probably long-term in nature, but they want to outperform the equity markets over time. And I'm happy to say we've managed to achieve all those in the past.
That sounds like a good plan. And how do you manage to achieve all of this? Tell us a bit more about your strategy and your founding principles.
Okay. So the principles of running the money are very simple. First of all, we want to use all the tools that are available, not just equities. Secondly, where prospective returns are very high and risk is low, we want to lock those returns in for as long as possible. So the longest duration asset is equities. So back in 82, when I started running this trust, valuations were extraordinarily cheap. Inflation had purged balance sheets. So every company looked in good shape. So risks were low and valuations were cheap. Inflation was high but falling. Interest rates were high but falling. And the prospective returns actually in every asset class looked pretty good. But the longest duration asset available was equities, and therefore we had a lot of equities at that stage. If you switch forward to the end of the 90s, the late 90s, the situation then was very different, that equities looked very expensive, and on our models suggested that you would make no return at all over the next 10 years. In real terms, which turned out to be about right. But bonds still look great. They're still offering 4% real yields. So we had a lot of bonds, not much equity, but a lot of bonds. In pursuance of that principle, a lot of duration. So 30-year bonds and that kind of investment. Situation today, unhappily, is that there are far fewer opportunities. So we still think that equities are very rich here and offer prospectively very poor returns over the next 10 years. But in contrast to that period in the 90s, bonds also, it's very clear, have very poor prospective returns as a whole, particularly nominal bonds. Where a very large number of high-quality bonds trade at negative yields. So the exception, we believe, is in index-linked bonds. And we have, as well as Capital Gearing Trust and its sister open-ended fund, which is called the Absolute Return, CG Absolute Return, we actually have run funds to allow investors to invest in index-linked government bonds around the world. So it's a CG Real Return Fund. And another fund specifically in TIPS, which is the American version of index-linked bonds. And we believe there's very significant capital gain to be made in those areas because the level of debt is so great that it's very clear we face a period of extended financial repression. By financial repression, I mean that we will have interest rates, which in nominal terms remain quite low, but will be well below the rates of inflation that prevail. And as a result of that, there is significant potential capital gain in index-linked. So that plays a role in Capital Gearing Trust as well, of course. We have about a 20% allocation to TIPS alone, the American version. and another 7 or 8% to the equivalents around the world. And that's always played a role, has the last 25 years played a role in allowing us not to have downturns. So we, in the 38 years of the history of Capital Gain Trust, we've had one downturn, which was 2%. This is on an annual basis, that's been because we've had negatively correlated assets within the portfolio, and we continue to do so. So it's worked pretty well.
Not bad at all. Not bad track record there, Peter. In terms of employee ownership, talk us through the structure of this, if you wish.
Okay, Katie. So in my quite long time in the city, I have worked both for companies and for partnerships. And I have no doubt at all which worked better for investors and indeed for the long-term future of the company, which is partnerships. So partnerships tend to stick together for a long period and take the long view about creating value. And so 2 years ago, we gave most of the firm to an employee ownership trust, which is like John Lewis or Waitrose. So the firm essentially belongs to its employees and always will. And that has two effects. One is that it makes it very unlikely to get sold to anybody else. And the other is that everyone within the firm takes a long view because they will be there a long time and get the benefits from long-term policies.
And maybe tell us a bit more about these long-term views and goals.
Okay. So I should say that the firm is established with three principles, which were really unfashionable in the business world, but I like to think are coming back more into fashion now. So the first is the client comes first, which has not been a characteristic of, I think it's fair to say, of a number of American companies. Secondly, don't be greedy, which again is, has been more unusual, perhaps is coming back more into fashion now. And the third is have fun. And by that, Katie, I don't mean to say that we have a party every day, but just that Monday morning is a good morning because people feel very satisfied by the work that they are achieving.
That sounds really, really good. And it's Monday morning now. We're having fun, aren't we?
So. Indeed we are.
Tell us a little bit more in detail, if you would, about your track record. You mentioned the year of downturn in the 38 years, but maybe just give us a bit more detail as to some of your successes.
Well, we're quite proud of our track record, actually, because in those 38 years, the share price is up 212 times, I think is the number currently. And the trust has grown. So we have a zero discount mechanism for the trust, which means that we always make sure that the price of the shares is very close to the asset value of the shares. In order to do that, we buy in shares if there are more sellers than buyers, and we issue shares if there are more buyers than sellers. And as a result of that, we have been issuing pretty consistently since we adopted this policy 4 years ago. And so the market cap is actually, I think, unique in history of investment trusts. So it's up 1,200 times since we started in 82.
Wow. Not bad at all. Before we let you go, give us a bit of an idea of some of your growth opportunities in 2021.
Okay. Well, as aforementioned, we think equity valuations are pretty rich. Mm-hmm. But the world we're looking at is going to be very interesting. So we think it will be characterized by rising inflation and very low real interest rates. Mm-hmm. Now, in the past, equities have been disadvantaged by inflation once it gets to 4% or so. They quite like it up till then, but once you get to 4%, they tend to perform very badly. But that's in part been because the reaction to that elevated inflation has been rising interest rates. So we don't think that second characteristic will kick in for some time. So it's quite interesting to see whether it's beneficial to equities or not at that stage. But what we are very sure of, or much more sure of anyway, is that where you have cash flows that are both predictable and index linked in some way, that the value of those cash flows will rise with falling real interest rates. So there are quite a lot of specialized property situations which fall into that category. There's various alternatives which we look at very carefully, although some of those are too richly priced, the premium's too high at the moment. Property looks better, specialized property looks better. And of course, we're looking at our tips, particularly as showing an opportunity or providing an opportunity to make some good money.
Mm-hmm. Sounds good to me. Well, fascinating talking to you, Peter. I'm sure we'll chat again in further detail. Thank you very much indeed for your time here on Proactive London with Peter Spiller here from Capital Gearing Trust.
Thank you, Katie.